Well, you've been crew, it's your boy Savon Thomas, back with another episode of Coffee and Comments. Today we're going to review the movie I Believe in Santa. Was it good? Was it trash? Let's talk about it, but first, let's take a sip. Welcome back, Bean Crew. On this episode of Coffee and Comments, again, we're going to review the movie I Believe in Santa. And really, the only reason I watched this movie, one, because it is Christmas time. Everybody loves, like, Christmas movies, cheesy Christmas movies during the holidays. And I was on Twitter, and I saw this tweet talking about this movie called I Believe in Santa. And they said, it was like a challenge. It was from Kyle Brandt, I believe, on Good Morning Football. And he put out a challenge, and he was like, I guess watch this movie, or can you stand this movie, or whatever. And this guy retweeted, and he was like, challenge accepted. And then I saw like the premise of the movie, and I'll read to you guys the premise of this movie. So it says, love is a gift, but when you find out the man you've fallen for still believes in Santa, do you accept it or send it back? Right? And that's kind of a, to start off, that's kind of a dumb plot, right? So the movie is about this couple. This woman meets this lawyer, who seems like a normal guy, like no like real obsessions. He's a lawyer, makes good money, does the whole deal, like seems like a normal guy. They meet in the summertime, so it's like she sees them, they've been dating I believe for like 5 months, but then it kind of escalates when it comes to Christmas, because he is a big Christmas guy, and even to the point that he actually still believes, has faith that Santa is real, right? And so the movie kind of plays on what most people think, like you grow up and you realize that Santa Claus isn't real. Like, most people, they buy presents for their kids. They tell their kids that Santa bought the presents. And it just plays on the fact that most people, you know, grow up and have that. But this guy has this faith and this belief as a, I don't know, maybe 35, 40, maybe 50-year-old man still believes, like, actually believes that Santa Claus is real. To the point that he's doing all these different, like, things and telling people to keep the faith, and like literally believes that Santa's going to deliver him, you know, whatever he believes in. And so it's an interesting movie plot. Like, I literally only watched it because I was like, this plot is trash. There's a challenge going on just to get through it and see what happens. And while I didn't like think it was a good movie, I didn't think it was the worst Christmas movie ever. Honestly, it just gave me Hallmark vibes. Like, literally, this movie would fit in so perfectly on Hallmark. My mother is a Hallmark queen. Like, she absolutely adores Hallmark movies, and it's like the same tropes of like big city boy or big city girl meets small town farmer and they work together. Like, it's all these different like holiday movies. You see it during Christmas time, you see it during like Halloween, things like that. These Hallmark holiday movies were like, things just kind of are just weird. And so that's kind of what this movie feels like, is a Hallmark movie. Like, it will fit perfectly on that. The writer who wrote this movie is actually the main actor. So two actors in this movie, John Ducey and Christina Moore, play the couple. There's a few other actors obviously in there as well, but they're the main stars of this movie. I wasn't familiar with either one. They haven't really been in too many different things that I've personally seen. I did look up Christina Moore. She was on That 70s Show, and for a little bit, she did play the sister of, what was it, the Foreman sister, Lori, I think is her name. I never really got into That 70s Show, but she was the replacement of Lori from That 70s Show. So, decent actors inside the movie. I mean, acting kind of just was cheesy as it is, but the story, again, it just follows like this guy that seems like a normal guy until Christmas time comes around. And what I found to be funny was the fact that he is his best friend, like, knew, like, going into it. He's like, I already know. He's like, have you told her about the whole Santa Claus thing? And, like, his best friend's kind of already, like, fought the battle of, like, this guy's kind of weird. But He just like, you know what, I accept him for who he is, right? And so it's kind of fun to see, like from the best friend side, like, he's just, like, watching this dude date this girl, and he's like, well, she's going to figure it out, and she's either going to keep dating you, or she's going to break up with you, right? And he kind of knows that, too. He's like, he kind of understands this thing. But overall, the movie, not a good movie, first of all, but there is parts of it that you can kind of enjoy. Like, he gives this long soliloquy of the Christmas spirit, and how, like, his belief in Santa really is more of a belief in the spirit of Christmas, and like how it brings people together, and just the holidays brings people together, and you should be happy about like Christmas for that reason. But then on top of that, he doesn't actually believe in Santa. So, like, if it feels like a movie talking about, like, the spirit of Christmas and, like, bringing people together, you got me on board with this movie. But the fact that the guy actually believes in Santa Claus is stupid in itself. And there is a good ending, and you see, like, fun things happen. But overall, I mean, the movie is kind of what you'd expect it to be. Cheesy Hallmark movie, not really that good. But if you just want to watch something for Christmas and see if it's, you know, enjoyable to you, see if you like it, check this out. It's on Netflix. That's where I watched it. I personally gave this a 5 out of 10. Kind of just like a run-of-the-mill movie, something you'd see. You know, it's not good. It's not the worst thing ever, but it's not good. So check it out on Netflix. It's on my light roast list. Let me know in the comments what your thoughts were, if you were able to get through it, and what you enjoy about the movie, what you didn't enjoy about the movie. But other than that, I appreciate you guys for tuning in to another episode of Coffee and Comments.